Well, hello, friends. Welcome to another episode of Finding a Better Way. I know it's been a long time, but I'm here. And here's another episode from the TMA conference. And I'm joined by a very special longtime friend of mine.
Hi, guys. I'm Rebecca Isaac Allen, and I'm a second year medical student.
Not only is she that, she's also my homegirl from high school. We go way back. I've known Becca since literally the ninth grade. And here we are now, bursting our way into the medical world, me as an intern, her as a second year, and we're at the TMA conference, and I just have done a video about this before, about why membership is important for students, and now I just kind of want to come at it from a new member's perspective and also a more seasoned member's from an intern's perspective. So, I know I'm seasoned. So, Rebecca, tell me what is it that has drawn you to be a part of this organization?
Well, I think there's a really great community that's at my school, and one of my dear friends who has really inspired me as just even just as a fellow medical student. He's an MS3, and he's truly involved with advocacy on a level that I haven't actually seen before. And so he's inspired me to really own where we are and know that we, even in our learning, can really make a difference in the way that things get legislated and discussed on an advocacy level at statewide specifically. And so he is a member of TMA. He's an incredible human being. And so in that same vein, really wanting to get connected and really wanting to network and really wanting to understand how this gets done for people who really need it, for people who look like me and you and really need us to really fight and make sure that their voices are heard as well for the betterment of everybody. And so I really understood and I'm starting to understand a little better about what that looks like, and I think TMA is a really great resource for students to really be able to jump off that platform and own it for the rest of their time as medical students, and even when we're training and further down the road in our careers. I think getting in that habit is crucial to the way that we function as doctors now. I don't think the two are separated. I don't know if they ever really have been. It's just become more clear to me as we move through these spaces that it's going to be a part of what I do as a doctor. And so I'm looking forward to learning and being a part of TMA and, you know, really, really representing as well. I think that's important.
All right. Well, I couldn't have said it better myself. Thank you so much for eloquently laying out you hit on so many good points there. Advocacy is kind of the theme, and that early exposure, I also would agree, is very important because it's like a language that you come to learn about how these things get done on like a legislative state level. It's a language I'm still learning, and I think you're right, that early involvement, the habit just kind of continues. We start early in our career getting exposure, learning that language, we can be better advocates for our patients, for those who are underserved and underrepresented. I think it is so important for us to start early and continue and pick up speed as we go. So I'm excited that you're here. It reminds me of why I'm here and how even now in training, getting even more insight into the practice side of things and how to apply the knowledge that we gain here at TMA meetings to my training and beyond. So I'm excited. I hope y'all are excited because, I mean, the future of medicine is here, especially the future of medicine in Texas. These are the budding physicians at the state and, you know, kind of getting primed and ready to take care of Texans and beyond as we move to other places, if we move on. So I just want to encourage any medical students or residents or young physicians out there to be involved with TMA. Just type in TMA and you'll get linked into their website. I'll link up some stuff in the descriptions of the YouTube video. And I just kind of wanted to share that again because I have reignited my passion recently. And so I wanted to just pop in on the blog and talk about it. So any last words, Rebecca?
Well, I think that it's a big responsibility, and I will not lie, it's overwhelming because it's not something that we've done naturally before. You know, me and Jasmine sat in high school government class, but we sit at a really bird's eye view, right? They look at it from a national perspective, not realizing the power of starting just in your own state and how powerful that can really be, especially because healthcare is regulated state by state in this sense. So it's actually overwhelming and it can be daunting. And I think that's the other reason why it's nice to have friends who want to join in on the journey and feel supported, and also us pull resources from the same place, share resources, experiences. So yes, absolutely. Please continue to follow Jasmine. She's fantastic. Disclosure, right? We're best of friends for a long time. However, I truly do believe that this is really important for us as women, for us as Black women, for us as future physicians. It's an important thing that you do. So I'm really proud of you.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks for watching, y'all. Yes. This has been fun.
Well, on that note, thank you so much. We'll be seeing you on the next episode of Finding a Better Way.
Want to connect more with Dr. Rowe? See her website listed below and follow her on social media.